Hi sir, how are you?
हेलो, गुड। हाउ आर यू?
I'm fine sir. So sir, today I want you to express your experience in UPSC preparation, sir. The way you became IPS officer and how did you crack it? How was your experience through all the difficulties and is there any difficulty in that and is it worth it, sir? So I'll start with the first question. When you got to know that you got the rank, what was your feeling, sir?
That was April 5th, 2019. So actually results are supposed to come in, maybe our interviews got over on March 29th itself. So usually within 3 or 4 days results should come out. That is the expectation generally. It's not that the rule, but expectation. But it took a week. Maybe this is the first time or first time since we started preparing, it took a week. It was so much high amounts of anxiety, so many negative thoughts build up into your mind, right? So suddenly when some positive results come out, these negative thoughts and this positive result collide and become zero. So blank was my state. I was completely blank. I was not thinking about anything. Like, you feel kind of burden removed from your shoulders, right?
Yes, sir.
So
after
it
a
took
long
me
journey.
Yeah, after a long journey, so many negative thoughts, so much efforts. So yeah, that day I felt a little blank. After a week or so, then a sense of accomplishment I felt.
Okay. That took a 1 week for you to, you know, get into your mind that you have done something.
Yes.
Wow. What is the first thing you did, sir, when you got to know that you got into the services?
Yeah, so I was outside with my friends because I couldn't stay at home. I wasn't able to sleep and all. I was alone at my home with my sister. My parents weren't here. So as soon as my friend told me about my result, so as soon as I came to know that, I called my father, then my brother and mother, and I told them that I got selected and so rank with so and so rank.
Awesome, sir. Great. Sir, how was your IPS training, sir?
IPS training has been very good.
What is the one of the most difficult thing you face, sir?
It's not difficult, I would say. Difficult, see, the important word here to note is training. You get trained to become something.
Yes.
So you will be continuously doing those things so that all those things shape you into a good person or good officer. Okay. So you get trained to become something. Everything will feel difficult in the initial stages. After that, it becomes regular.
Okay.
It becomes common. You understand your duties, what kind of responsibilities you have, what are the expectations from you. So it's
okay.
Pretty
so
good.
When you have to wake up, sir, in the morning during the
it
training?
Depends. For suppose our if our fall in is at 5:20 or 5:15, I wake up at 4:45. If our fall in is at 5:45, we wake up at 5:15. If it's at 6. So half an hour grace period. How much time you need to get freshen up and fall in?
That depends on you.
On that. It depends on the fall in time.
Fall in time. Okay. So is it like you have to come at this, you know, this time this thing is happening. At the end, this is the end time. You have to sleep by 10 o'clock. Is there something
no,
like
no,
that?
No, there is nothing like that. There is only schedule. You have to present for the schedule on time. What you do in your own personal time is of no importance for them.
Who are the people who are going to train you in the training center, sir?
We have IPS officers and then assistant commandant who clear through CAPF exam.
Yes.
Then there are inspector level officers. Then there are head constable level officers, constable level officers. Head constable level officers are the ones who actually train us, who run with us. Okay, so we call them ustads. So outdoor is different, indoor is different. In indoors, normal IPS officers act as a faculty. For law subjects, there is a non-uniformed faculty who is a lawyer, I mean judge. Then for outdoors, it's mostly inspector level officer and head constable level officer. They both take care of us.
Okay. So, sir, is there a scope for making friends and all that in the training, sir?
Yeah, absolutely. You will make, because everybody struggles there, right? So, sir, suppose our batch is 170 people. So
okay.
169 people struggle along with me. So you
yeah.
have a common thing to connect about, right? So obviously we'll make very good friends.
So it's like after the battle you guys are like meeting. You won the war and meeting like that.
You put it in a good way, yeah. But yes, we do make very good friends.
Awesome, sir. Sir, what do you think is the most important part in UPSC exam preparation, sir? Prelims, mains, interview. What is the main thing that we have to concentrate for an aspirant who is dreaming to be in your position right now? What is the main thing that they have to concentrate?
One thing is be very genuine with yourself. And when you are genuine to yourself, you know that if you would be able to crack or not. And if you think you would be able to crack, be patient. Because exam is going to be a very lengthy process. It almost takes 10 months is the exam process. 10 months is the exam process itself. In that, we effectively study for 6 months or seven, 6 months at max. 3 months for prelims, 3 months for mains. If you qualify for interview, well, in 1 month you may study. That's not exactly studying, but... So you need a lot of patience here and need to, and your thought process cannot fluctuate over these 10 months of period. You should be very focused. By very focused, I don't mean that get zoned out and live a sadhu kind of life. You need not do that. But your goal and your ambition should always be in your head. These are the two important things which I would say.
Okay. Always keep your eye on the goal.
Keep your eye on the goal. Relax yourself. But that doesn't mean that whatever you have studied till now, you forget by relaxing today and tomorrow starting. No.
How often one should relax and what kind of relaxation one should go for, sir?
It depends on everybody. On day-to-day basis, relaxation means talking to friends or talking to family.
Okay, sir. I will put the question in this way. What are the types of relaxations we should avoid?
Obviously, excessive social gathering, okay, or alcohol or smoking or whatever it is. See, these are personal choices. Nobody can deny them. But you obviously have to limit these things. Okay. Any kind of addiction is bad.
Yes.
As long as it's helping you, it's fine. But once if it's harming you, there is no way you shouldn't continue with that at all. So obviously excessive social gatherings, becoming a party, because again, that if you're going to Delhi, many people are like you only here, so you can connect with many people there. Okay, it's very easy to be socialized in such places. So that socializing process shouldn't lead you to a wrong way, it should lead you to a correct way.
Productive, you're productive doing something way. About UPSC and
exactly.
Cool, sir. Sir, the prelims is coming in 8 days, sir, from today, and sir, what is the best strategy to follow in this 80 days, and how did you prepare for your how did you make your strategy?
For me, see, these are times have changed, because when I came, one thing which always struck in my mind was initially, just like every other candidate, I was also researching so much about UPSC, googling stuff. They're downloading so much of content,
yes.
Watching so many videos. It was all overwhelming for me.
Yes.
This happens with everybody. See, UPSC Civil Services Examination is such an exam where you can Google for years together, still you cannot crack it.
Yeah.
So one thing which I realized from my coaching was you can limit your resources. Conveniently, you can limit your resources. Limiting doesn't mean not covering a topic. Limiting doesn't mean medieval history don't come and go off. You study that too, but only one book or two books you follow it if you want to.
Okay.
So limit your resources first. Main important thing is limiting our resources. Okay. Second thing is revision. Always, see, this is the process how it happens. When you study a book, you go and attempt a few questions. Then you realize, this was not the way I should study this subject. You get a feedback, then you apply that feedback and study again. Then you go and make mistakes. Then again, you get a feedback that I should make these corrections. So this is a continuous loop which could be running. What is this loop? This loop means that you are revising continuously. So the idea is to study well and make very less amount of mistakes in the exam. Okay, so this should be the basic strategy. So limit your resources, revise a lot of times, see where you are making mistakes, revise your test series, take feedback from them, from your mentors or from yourself. You get the best feedback from yourself, I would say that. Always follow the syllabus. Okay. Somebody may be saying something extraordinary, but you need not worry about that. Once it's not in the syllabus, first cover what's in the syllabus. Then you can go for extraordinary steps. Okay. Yes, eventually, it's just an exam. First, you consider it an exam. Don't make it a life process.
Yeah.
Okay. So, the thing is, limit your content, revise, take feedback, attempt to test, understand where your mistakes are, again read, again repeat. This whole process shall keep on repeating.
Yes, sir. This is a wholesome strategy, right? What right now you have described is a wholesome strategy, how we have to prepare.
Yes,
sir,
yeah.
Sir, this for the whole year, if we have 1 year, we can do like this. We have to do like this only. If not, we can't do it. That's proper. For 80 days, sir.
Okay.
For 80 days. For this next around 3 months maximum. What to do for this 3 months, sir?
In 80 days, that means 20 plus 30 plus 30, right?
Yes.
So first 20 days, make sure that you have assumed that the exam is going to be on June 1st week.
Yes.
Okay. So you would have prepared a mindset, you would have been prepared for that exam.
Now it's now October 4th, sir.
October 4th. Yes. So with passage of time, you would have lost that mindset little, right?
Yes.
So utilize first 20 days to get back to that mindset again. So till May last week, whatever you have constructed, use these 20 days to reconstruct it again and get back to that level.
Okay.
Okay. Because you would have lost something, obviously. Your mindset would have that focus would have been lost or whatever it is. So initial 20 days, 2 weeks, at least 2 weeks, I would say. 20 days is too much.
Mentally prepare also.
Mentally prepare it. What all things you have done? Reconstruct yourself. What was your thought process and all? How did you prepare and reach that ready to do the exam now level? So get back to that level. Then 1 month you revise. Again, I would say revise only. Revise all the things, okay? Within these first 20 days, get that flow, and next 30 days, the flow should be very intense. You can revise everything, take out your test series and all. And the important thing is don't neglect CSAT paper 2. Okay, CSAT paper 2 is a big deal now, even for engineers.
Yes.
I could have failed CSAT paper 2 this year. I think I passed it by a narrow margin, 1 or 2 marks.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure about that. So don't neglect that. So revise everything. Again, get back to basic stuff. Take each subject one by one. How confident are you about it? Study, read it. Because you have time. Don't worry about time at all. 80 days is ample amount of time. Because you have already come to a preparation level by May mid. Now you have to just get back to it again.
Yeah.
From there, revise current affairs. And one more thing which many people wouldn't be able to understand is will there be questions from Corona and all?
Yeah.
I feel that there won't be questions from Corona topic because nothing has been conclusive about Corona yet.
Yes.
Nothing has been conclusive. There is no conclusion regarding medicine or vaccine or treatment or how it is, what kind of transfer, I mean, is it airborne or contagious or what is it? Nothing has been conclusive. Just read what WHO has been saying. Okay, normal articles which have made headlines. Okay, don't see. Eventually, for 4 marks or so, you cannot keep 96 marks, 96 questions at stake. For two questions, you cannot keep 98 questions at stake.
Yes.
So don't think much about this. Just get back to where you were on March, May 15th. That should be your plan.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the scheme regarding this Atmanirbhar, it's like there are some schemes
obvious.
To combat those are there, right?
A few obvious Atmanirbhar scheme there, PM CARES fund is there.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
These are obvious things. These are nothing.
We have to concentrate on that. It's not like anything related to Corona, we should leave. It's not like that.
Not like that. You obviously have to concentrate. But don't
but the
focus
questions
on
will
corona
be like.
As,
Because for the past 3-4 months, for the past 6 months, around all the topics are about Corona only.
Corona.
But the questions in the percentage, it will become coming like only 5%.
Very, very
of the
less.
Will be,
very, very less. Very, very less. That's
so
what the main idea is to be be ready to the readiness level where you are in May mid.
Maybe.
That is the main thing. If you can achieve that, I think you are well prepared.
Okay, we have
after
to go
that,
back to...
Exactly. That mindset, that confidence, you have to reach. That's it.
Done, sir. Sir, next question. How many test series should a person attempt before prelims, sir?
See, attempt test series in this process only. Study and then take your own feedback, and in that process, take any test series.
Yes.
But don't go for just gaining a feeling of I have attempted 100 tests, hence I should be able to qualify. No.
The quality is important.
The quality is very important. See, eventually everything comes to what you have studied only. How many tests you have attempted is well and you have to attempt as many as possible. I would say 50, 60, 70, any number is good. But you have to make use of those tests also. You have to make sure that your accuracy is improving test by test. Okay. You must be able to understand what are your weak areas. Take a note of them. Last 15 days or 10 days, you focus on them. Okay. From test. It's not like you simply write a test. Oh, I have got these marks, so I leave your book. No. You take a test. You understand what kind of right answers you have made in the test. And how are you able to achieve to the right answer. Go to the right answer. Okay, that mindset you have to develop. Then why were you able to make mistakes? So consciously analyze through tests. Don't just think on the number of tests. Any number of tests is good enough.
Okay. So,
but basically, yeah, one test series you are expected to follow. One test series
fully.
You are expected to follow fully. Those pass section wise tests and the full length tests.
Okay, sir. So that's... Sir, so the test series we have to follow one is minimum. We have to follow one test
one
series.
One is minimum.
Minimum we have to do that.
After that, generally what happens is we get fed up with studying and all. We think we have studied it all. So we want to continuously check ourselves if we are performing well. Our performance has not deteriorated or not. So there you can go for excessive number of tests. And then again in any stage, the idea should be to correct your mistakes and learn something new.
Sir, so finally, coming to the end, what is your final advice to the students who are preparing in this COVID time, sir?
COVID times, see, mentally, it's going to be a very challenging thing because you're isolated, you're only with your family. Okay, it's mentally very challenging. Everything has become digital. Digital is such a medium where you are unsure. For example, initially, when I told you, you keep on digging the material. It's infinite over there. Similarly, many videos would be coming there. Many, many things would be coming. So what I would say is avoid digital. If you need, you use digital. For example, for any classes or something like that, use digital media. Otherwise, just follow the news of RSTV or any other channel you prefer and try to avoid which is the digital thing. And see, again, the exam is a mental game as well. See, mental strength is very important for the exam. So take this as a challenge. Challenge yourself. How well you can see, everything shall pass. So this shall too pass. So don't worry about that. Take this as a challenge. Become strong yourself. Spend quality time with family. You can take this as an opportunity also. See, it's equally challenging for everybody. This
yes.
Mental strength. So whoever has that mental strength will come out. So this is also a factor for the exam. So develop that mental strength and focus. Be focused.
Yes. Thanks, sir. Thanks for giving such valuable advice for students for prelims today. And hope we will be doing a session on mains also. Thanks a lot, sir.
No problem.